This is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today I have another exciting episode for you, and I'm here at the second annual Heirloom Expo, and there's a big sign behind me, and we're here in the Hall of Flowers building, and there's all kinds of different varieties of produce. But what this episode is going to be about is my one super favorite booth at the Heirloom Expo, where they're teaching some really cool cutting edge stuff that you guys have probably not heard anywhere else. So let's head over to that booth and find out what they're sharing today. Now we're at the booth of Biologic Systems, and this is my favorite booth by far at the whole Heirloom Expo. And many people are just walking by it, but they don't really know what's here. And I do, because if you guys are a previous viewer, you saw a few episodes ago when I went to that place in Portland where they're basically supersizing their plant growth with wood chips. And what do I find now in a bag? This is actually California humus. This is 100% wood chips that's been decomposed basically with a fungus dominant composting. Most composts use actually high heat for a rapid turnaround, and they don't have the special benefits that this stuff does. I mean, this is basically just the wood chips compost that you could buy if you don't have a lot of land space to just dump wood chips and let it happen naturally over 3 to 5 years. And check this stuff out. This stuff just looks like that same black gold that I saw in that Portland garden where they're supercharging and super growing super large dinosaur kale. If you didn't see that episode, check a couple episodes back for that episode. So proud to announce that they got this here. Today what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over and talk to some of the guys here and learn more about the humus, what it is, and why this works so well to supercharge your plant growth. Now we're here with Ian from Biologic Systems, and Ian, I wanna ask you a couple questions. You know, what is soil humus? And how does it get to grow these pumpkins really big and that dinosaur kale that I saw in that other garden really big? I mean, what's going on?
Well, soil humus is the component of soil that microbes have actually broken down dead organic matter to create. So if you think about the forest floor, if you're out walking in a forest, every year those trees are dropping all of their leaves down on the ground, leaving that litter on the surface of the soil. Well, fungi have evolved in the soil to break that litter material down and decompose it into what's called soil humus. So a healthy soil contains billions of microorganisms in every teaspoon of it. And those organisms work to help these plants to grow so big. So the world record giant pumpkin growers have figured this out, that they're actually able to grow better, bigger pumpkins based on an organic method utilizing soil humus, adding compost products into their soils that help to increase the soil humus level, and they're actually seeing that they're getting better results by doing that than by using the synthetic products to get the pumpkins to grow big. So soil humus, you want to think of it as this ecosystem of thousands of different types of microorganisms that are growing together and are working symbiotically with the plant to help to build more topsoil. So when you look at our conventional agricultural systems, what they're really lacking is this soil humus. They've applied chemicals, they've used tillage, which has killed off all this biodiversity of these microbes. And now the plants have no microbes growing with them, so they pretty much have no immune system. And so you see all the problems with disease, with pests, etc. So the best growers in the world, looking at large-scale farmers, looking at giant pumpkin growers, they're all learning that they're going to get better results by utilizing organic methods and working to build the humus content in their soils.
Wow. Yeah, so man, I've been telling you guys for the longest time, work on building your soils. This is a new subject matter that I'm learning about, and we're going to head over to their booth and learn more about the food soil web and how it can help you to grow monster-sized pumpkins, monster-sized dinosaur kale, or even monster-sized tomatoes. Now we're here with Ian at their booth, and we're gonna go over what the soil food web is. So Ian, what is a soil food web, and how does it contribute to healthy plants?
So the soil food web is a term used to describe the whole community of microorganisms that live in the soil. And there's four different types of organisms. There's bacteria, fungi, protozoa, and nematodes. So in a single teaspoon of soil, you can have billions of those different organisms in there. The soil food web is a term that is used to describe how they relate to one another. So when you have, in nature, you have plants that grow and they eventually die. When they die, they leave that dead material laying on the surface of the soil. And that's where the bacteria and fungi come in first, and they gobble up all that dead plant material. And so all the nutrients that are in that plant now become bacteria and fungi. Well, in order to make those nutrients available to the plant once again, it requires the soil predators. So in the soil, there are predators just like in the ocean.
where you have sharks as a predator, or in a pasture system, you have wolves as a predator. Well, the soil has predators too. In the soil, the predators are nematodes and protozoa. So what they do is all day long, they eat away at that bacteria and fungi, and they're literally pooping out all of the nutrients that were held in that bacteria and fungi as available nutrients that the plant can once again take up. So you have this constant process going on where the microbes are making nutrients available for the plant that the plant can uptake. The plant is dying and the microbes are eating the plant and turning it back into stable soil humus.
So what's this diagram you got here? Can you go over this for everybody?
Absolutely. So on the diagram, this shows how initially you have plants that grow using sunlight, and eventually that plant dies. So now here you've got dead organic matter, your litter layer laying on the surface of the soil. Fungi and bacteria come in and eat that dead material. And so now all the nutrients that were in the plant and in the dead plant are now transferred into the bacteria and fungi. Those bacteria and fungi are then consumed by the soil predators, primarily the nematodes and protozoa, that are eating that bacteria and fungi and releasing the nutrients back in a plant available form. So in the example of nitrogen, you have all this nitrogen in the plant. It's now stored in the dead plant. The bacteria is eating the dead plant. Nitrogen is now turning into the bacterial biomass. And when that protozoa eats that bacteria, it's pooping out all that nitrogen in the form of ammonium, NH4, which is plant-available soluble nitrogen. So if you've got 100,000 protozoa in every gram of your soil, which is common in a good, healthy, organic soil, those protozoa can produce more nitrogen than your plant can even possibly take up. So this is how we're seeing, even in a lot of the large-scale agricultural context we're working in, we can reduce the fertilizer input on these farms by up to 50% because we're using the microbes to make the majority of the fertilizer for the plants on the farm in the soil.
Wow, so that's really cool, man. So I know you have like a slide and a high-power microscope. Can you show us actually what that looks like, you know, in a, under a microscope?
What we're looking at here on the screen today is we've got a nematode, one of our four food groups of microorganisms. And this particular nematode is called a bacterial feeding nematode. So in healthy soil, in every teaspoon of that soil, you're gonna have hundreds of these tiny little nematodes. And what this guy's doing is he's eating bacteria as we're watching him right here in the soil. The image that we're looking at is a little bit of soil that we put under the microscope that's at 400 magnification. So this is about a 400th of a drop of a liquefied soil. So this little nematode here is eating all these bacteria. You can see the tiny little single-celled bacteria swimming around here in the background. Well, this nematode is gonna eat 50,000 of those bacteria every day. And as he eats each one of those bacteria, he's pooping out plant-available nitrogen that is fertilizer for your plants. So as we build these beneficial organisms up to really high levels in the soil, we can then be producing fertilizer for the plant without having to use hardly any inputs at all.
So you explained how the process works, but you know, how does the California humus, where does this come in and what does this do exactly?
Well, California humus is a composted material that's made from 100% woody material. So we work with a tree service company to utilize all the waste, all of the wood chips that they bring back on a daily basis. And we put it into a 3-year composting process. That's a low temperature composting method that really allows all these beneficial fungi and nematodes and protozoa to grow well. Most commercially produced compost is made at a very high temperature where they're turning the piles up to every day. And in that really hot temperature where they're turning constantly, really the only microorganism that grows in that type of a compost is bacteria. Well, what we really want to grow in our California humus are the other organisms, the nematodes, protozoa, and the beneficial fungi. So this material right here, in a teaspoon of this stuff, there's over 10,000 different species of microorganisms. And what you can do at home is take this humus and you can make it into a tea by taking an old sock or a t-shirt, putting it inside of there, and take a garbage can full of water, extract the compost out into the water, and now you got 30 to 50 gallons of a tea that you can take and spread around all your garden, your lawn, spray it on your house plants, and it's gonna work to restore all these beneficial microorganisms into your plant growing system to help your plants grow better, to help them uptake nutrients, to help to prevent from disease. It's basically working to rebuild the immune system of the plant, just as we have an immune system. Our immune system is built on microorganisms just like the plants is, so they're really not much different than us. In order to thrive and be healthy, they need this whole community of these beneficial organisms to help the plant to thrive.
Wow, it's totally amazing. So, you know, I know my viewers may want this now. I mean, this is pretty much what powered that garden in Portland that you guys saw, that supercharged the dinosaur kale, it supercharged the pumpkins, and it could supercharge your guys' garden too. You guys just need to get this stuff. So Ian, how can people get a hold of this stuff?
Well, you can find us, our company is Biologic Systems, and you can find us online at biologicsystemsusa.com.
Awesome, Ian, thanks so much for sharing today.
Right.
So hopefully you guys now know how to supercharge your plant growth with the California humus. I'm definitely gonna be starting to use this now, and I'm gonna even have larger plants than before, hopefully the size of my friends in Portland. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and remember, keep on growing.